Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. We're working on the GTR again today. In yesterday's video, I buttoned up the Army Trix exhaust. We got that from James at Vivid Racing. Gave us a great deal on it. You know, I mean, he had it in stock fast. I mean, he shipped it to us. We had it in a day or two, so I appreciate that. But I got the exhaust on. I got underneath all buttoned up. I did get the tips on. I made the mistake of putting the bottom panels on. I wanted to put the tips on last, and then I had to take the bottom panels off again to put the tips on to tighten them from underneath. But love the way the tips look. But today, to finish up the mods we're doing to it, we've got the turbo inlet pipes that have all been handmade here. We're gonna get those on, and I've got the Cobb bypass valves as well. Now I'm taking the bypass valves out, the bypass valves will be coming off to take all the stuff off to put the inlet pipes on. But so when I put them on, I'll just be putting the aftermarket ones on. But yeah, we got, like I showed in yesterday's video, you can't see any of the vacuum lines or any of the electrical for the valved exhaust. That's all hidden, nice and clean looking OEM. This job does look like it could be a little bit labor intensive. You've heard me say it before, guys, I do think that anything is possible, but way deep down in there, it's all black, you can't see it, is where those inlet pipes are. I have a feeling, I've looked at it, I've had it up on the hoist and looking around. I didn't put the front shield underneath this because I have a feeling I'm gonna have to go through this firewall to get to the bottom bolt on the inlet pipe for this side, and the same thing for this side here. So I didn't put that shield on because I figured it'd give me a little more access. But we're gonna start plucking away at it. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the charge piping off, take that off, take this off. This valve is what's gonna be replaced with the new Cobb. So I'll take that right off. I'm gonna take the air box out. That's gonna give me a little bit more room, which is gonna let me access down in there a little bit better. Then we're gonna do the same on this side. So I'm gonna start plucking away and getting this stuff taken off. And I'll give you updates as we're going. I have a feeling we're gonna run into a couple little things where, like, looking at it, it's hard to see on the camera, but there's little brackets and everything that's hooked to the that's bolted to the side of the inlet pipe, which I'm imagining I'm gonna have to try and get off before I pull the inlet pipe out. But we'll see. Like I said, I'm gonna start working on it, and we'll give you updates as we're going along. If I run into anything that I feel like is important to note for anybody doing this on their own, I'll definitely stop and show you guys. This has nothing to do with what we're doing here. I just thought it'd be interesting to point out, for some reason, it's painted green inside the intake manifold. Like, that's, I don't know. I don't know if it's for, it's very smooth, so I don't know if it's a smooth air rough, or not too sure, but definitely weird. But anyway, so we got this stuff off. Again, I still need to take this pipe off, but you can see, as I was talking about, down in there, those brackets right there beneath me have to come off because those are bolted onto the inlet pipes. I am gonna have to get, like I said, I'm gonna feel like I have to get into the wheel well to get those, but I'll get this clamp off, I'll get this box out of here, that'll give us a little bit more room. And then there's a bunch of little hoses and stuff down there that need to come off as well. So a little bit of playing around, but like I said, a little bit of time and some patience, we should be good to go. All right. So, an update. We are not going to change the inlet pipes on the GTR. Now, the reason for that is we might put a catch can on because there's a bit of oil in the intake pipe, but I'm going to see if I can see it down there. If you can see down in there, well, let me see if I can get this angled right here. Now, I'm not sure if you can see down in there, but let's see here. So right there, that's where the inlet pipe. See, now it's not focusing here, guys. Sorry about that. Right down there, if you see at the bottom where the inlet pipe meets the turbo, and you're looking way past, like down inside the tube there. I'm trying to get it to focus, guys. I'm sorry. It focuses for a second and then goes all out of blur. But if you see it down in there, see if that'll focus now. No. Nope. Sorry, guys. Anyway, down inside there, the inlet pipe meets the turbo perfectly. And this up here at the top of the intake, right, is 2 1/4 inch ID inside diameter. Now, I took it off. This one is a 2 1/4 inch inside diameter. And this right here is a 2 inch flange that meets exactly with the turbo. So there's actually a lip in there. You can't see it there. I don't know if I can see that. But there's actually a lip inside there. See, I'm flicking my thumb on it. I can hang my finger on it, like it's a pretty big lip. Okay? Which means when that goes on there, and I put that on there, the 2 inches that meets up to the turbo is the exact 2 inches that that one there has, that this one here has. And the 2 1/4 inch pipe, it's the same. The only difference is that the stock pipe is smooth on the inside, has a nicer airflow, as where this one here is pie cut the way he did it. Now, if I could see this, I would still throw it on, right? If it was sitting up top or something, because it looks cool, nice weld job, great quality workmanship, like the part is fantastic. But when you read online, all the guys that are making power changing those out are from the 07 or 08 or whatever it is, 09, I don't know what it is, to the 2011. And most people, when they upgrade those pipes, let's say you have a 2010, they upgrade that pipe from the 2010 to the 2012 plus. This is a 2015. I've already got the big ones on there. So on a 2010, if what I just read was correct, and I mean, definitely you guys can correct me if I'm wrong. I'm just what I read on a form there, because I was questioning whether or not that's worth replacing. On the form that I just read, the 2010, if you replace the inlet pipes with those stock inlet pipes from the 2012 and on, you can pick up with a tune like 29 peak horsepower, wheel horsepower, which is really impressive. I mean, for those pipes, throw the intake pipes on there, an extra 30 horsepower with a tune, that's great value. For this car, because it's already got 45 horsepower more than the older generation, I'm not gaining any horsepower by putting those inlet pipes on there. So instead of wasting my time and the money on those pipes, they were nice pipes. They were like $450 Canadian, I think they were. I am going to put the bypass valves on, the Cobb bypass valves. I'm going to put those on. But I think rather than take those pipes out, I'm going to sell these intake pipes. So if anybody's got a 2008 or 9, I don't know when the GT car came out, to a 2011 and want upgraded pipes, you're going to gain 30 horsepower with those pipes. And I'll probably take that money, and I'm looking at a JCR carbon intake, like the intake manifold, which is huge power gains, peak torque and power. I think that the money's better off going there than onto these here. I just don't think that it's worth it. So I'm going to button this back up, guys. I'm going to throw this back together. I'm not too far into it, so it shouldn't take me too long. I'm going to put it back together. I'll throw the bottom skid plate on. I'm going to get the GTR off of the hoist. We're going to be done with it until it gets down to toge tuning for Sasha from On Point Dyno, who's going to be doing the dyno tuning on it. And I will make sure I get lots of video footage of that and get that up, along with some sound clips of the exhaust and whatnot. But the crappy old Mustang, you know, living the Ford life, it started leaking antifreeze yesterday, so it's been sitting here since yesterday, and I need the hoist to put it on. So I'm going to get the GTR off the hoist. I'm going to bring the Mustang in, get it on the hoist, and see if we can figure out what's going on with the Mustang as well. So I'm going to button this up. I don't think I need you guys to see it because it's nothing. It's just putting on the intake pipes and what I just took off, which was pretty simple stuff. We'll get this off the hoist, get the Mustang on the hoist, and I'll show you what's going on with it. All right, so again, GTR is done. Waiting for tuning over there now. Crappy old Mustang back up on the hoist because it's pissing antifreeze out. I couldn't see anywhere that it was leaking except for right around here. It looked like it was leaking out of this hose, which is surprising because, I mean, it's been on there now for months and never had a problem. This clamp, the big clamp, the stock clamp, was over here. So I just moved it to the side and I put that other clamp on there just to see if it stops the leak or not. I see even right now, there's a bit of sweating coming out of the bottom there. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's still sweating a bit. So I'm not sure if that clamp's going to work. But if that's where it's leaking from, then I'll just replace that hose. It's a hose comes down, hooks into these two that run through the cooler and then back up. So I think I'm going to leave that for the night and see if that's what the problem is. And if it continues to leak, and if it does continue to leak, I'll have to buy a different hose, put a different hose on there.
Well, that's the Mustang life. If you own a Mustang, half time it's up on the hoist because, you know, Ford. But I'll let you guys know if that's what the problem is. I'm not sure if that's what the problem is. Like I said, we finished up the GTR. I will be getting that down to the dyno. I will be doing the install and the meth tank in this car as well. That'll be coming in the next couple days. Then it'll be going down to the dyno to get dyno tuned. So lots going down to the dyno. Lots of exciting stuff going on. We did get out. We are getting out and getting the body panels on the Supra. So the door skins are already on. That video is coming. We've got the rear quarters that are going on. So we are working on the Supra. Again, I keep saying it, the samples are coming. We just figured out our last couple colors to throw in for the vote. But for those of you that are new to the channel, this channel is actually about the 97 Toyota Supra that we're building. It's getting a Veilside 4509 GTR kit on it. Everything we do to the car gets voted on by you guys, the subscribers. And when we're done, we will have $100,000 or more into the car. We will be giving it away to one lucky subscriber. So if you're not subscribed to the channel, definitely hit that subscribe button. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff. And we'll see you in the next video.